Okay, so let's now continue with the same topic, concept of an electronic engine control system. Now consider an electronic engine control system that regulates fuel flow to the engine. And electronic engine control system is an assembly of electronic and electromechanical components that continuously varies the fuel and spark settings in order to satisfy government exhaust emission and fuel economy regulations. So as we discussed in the previous topic, that to satisfy the government regulation about the exhaust emission gases and the fuel economy, there's only way that we include the electronic engine control system into the automobiles. With the help of that, there will be a contribution of lot many sensors for input to the electronic engine control unit, and that electronic engine control will take further action to operate accordingly as per the input parameters. So the output will vary according to the input parameters. The electronic engine control system receives input electrical signals from various sensors that measure the state of the engine. Like in the previous unit, we discussed about the manifold air pressure sensor or coolant temperature sensor or NOx sensor and so on. So all those sensors are an input electrical signal. From these signals, the controller generates output electrical signals, which goes to the actuator and which determine the correct fuel delivery and spark timing. So this is one of the generic electronic engine control system diagram where sensors are shown. Sensor give input to the electronic control unit ECU, and it processes the information, and based upon the previous data which is stored, or programming or algorithm which is written for it, based upon that it processes the data and gives instruction to the actuator, and through actuator directly instruction goes to the engine and then to the power and exhaust. That means the final effect of the sensor comes to the power of the engine or exhaust of the engine. There is a fuel metering system to set the air fuel mixture flowing into the engine through intake manifold, as we need to check how much amount of air is going inside or how much amount of fuel is mixing with the air. So for that purpose, we use a fuel metering system. The spark control determines when the air fuel mixture is ignited after it is compressed into the cylinder of the engine. So once the complete mixture is compressed, then at what time a spark should be given to ignite the mixture. So that is again the parameters which are decided by ECU. So this is one of the engine functions and control diagram. Through this function you can see that there is a air flow coming from this left hand side, then there is a throttle plate angle, then there is a manifold air pressure sensor, then there is a fuel metering system. So this is the input to the engine control, and here comes the output for fuel metering. Then through that the engine is connected. Again there is an engine status sensor. Here we can consider that temperature sensor, which is going to check the temperature of the engine, coolant sensor. Through this, the input is given to the ignition, and finally there are spark ignition timings and all those which are connected to the engine. Finally, from the engine, the power is given to the driver shaft, and also the exhaust valve is here, where we have catalytic converter, then exhaust emissions. This is exhaust gas oxygen concentration. So it gives input to the engine control. If there is a excessive exhaust gases or oxygen concentration is present in the emission gases, then it gives an input to the engine control, and as per that, this system is again calibrated. This is the valve which get open for exhaust gas recirculation. So the gases which are useful, which do not involve the hydrocarbon content, that can be used again over here. The power is delivered at the drive shaft, and the gases that result from combustion flow out of the exhaust system. In the exhaust system, there is a valve to control the amount of exhaust gas being recirculated back to the input. So this valve we are talking about, and a catalytic converter to further control the emissions. In addition, there is a subsystem that collects the evaporating fuel vapors in the fuel tank to prevent them from being vented to the atmosphere. These fuel vapors are later sent to the intake system as a small component of fuel being supplied to the engine. This system is denoted as EVAP. At one stage of development, the electronic engine control consisted of separate subsystems for fuel control, spark control, and exhaust gas recirculation. The ignition system shows as a separate control system, although engine control is evolving toward an integrated digital system. Now, there are various input to the controllers. The major physical quantity data sensed and provided to the electronic controller as input are as follows. There can be a throttle position sensor, there will be a mass airflow rate sensor, engine temperature, or we can consider it as coolant temperature. All these sensors we have already studied, but now these sensor gives input to the ECU unit. Then engine speed, that means RPM and angular position, exhaust gas recirculation valve position sensor, exhaust gas oxygen concentration sensor. So some topics we will cover in this unit also. The output which we get from the ECU are fuel metering control, ignition control, exhaust gas recirculation control, fuel tank evaporative emission control. So in the next topic, in the next lecture, we'll start with the electronic fuel control system. Thank you.